Well, hello everyone, and welcome to episode 212 of the 64 Bypass Update. Today we'll be taking a look at the bridge girders at the I-73 bridge, and then we'll move over to the Zoo connector area. So we take off near the I-73 bridge, and as we've mentioned before, they've been working the last three nights putting up girders. They work from 11:30 p.m. until about 5 a.m. I believe. They have the big road here blocked off or closed down and detoured around this area so they can work safely through the night hours, early morning hours. And it looks like maybe one more night might finish them up, and they'll be complete with the girders up for the bridge here. It's looking pretty impressive, isn't it? Those are huge girders. If you're there near them, when you drive by underneath, you can see how large they are. They're just massive. So this flying around like this gives us a good view of the girders and what is left to do there. They have the one section left. They're getting about a fourth of them put up each night that they work. Six girders go up just about every night that they work, looks like. Six more will get them done. Okay, so we're going to leave this area, and since we're over near this other bridge work that's going on down here at the Little River, we'll fly down here. This is heading back toward Mack Road, and we'll take a look to see if any progress is being made down here. I see trucks rolling, some dozers pushing dirt, excavator doing some digging down here. You see the support columns for the bridge over on the far side there. And the land's been built up on that side over there where the white truck is, the right level for the bridge. Now this is looking back at the other side. Straight overhead and looking straight down at them, and you see they're digging out here with the excavator. It looks like they're preparing the area for the bridge foundation on this side of the bridge here. Now right here we get a very good comparison of these two trucks they've been using. The truck on the left that he's loading there is the Caterpillar 740, and the one on the right is the 777, and look how much larger it is. It looks like it's twice as wide and just a little bit longer. The 740 on the left can carry about 40 ton of material, and the 777 they say can carry 100 tons. So I was glad to get that view of them there. That gives a good comparison of the two trucks that we've been seeing over the past few months. Now as we look on up ahead, we see a truck loaded down with dirt, and he's moving up to an area up here where he's going to dump. Very seldom that I ever see them make a mistake in where they put their material, but I believe this guy slipped up a little bit. Just watch what he does here. He first thought this is where this load of dirt needs to go. Just about now, he realized, oh, I wasn't supposed to put that here. So what does he do? Reaches up on the dash, hits that redo button, and pulls that dirt back up on the truck again. He'll find him another place to put it. Ain't modern technology something? Okay, now we're moving back toward I-73 up the hill here. Take one more look over toward the bridge girders. The traffic driving underneath them. Now we're going to land the drone. I'm flying the Mavic 2 Zoom. We're going to land it here and we're going to go over to the Zoo Connector area where the road leaves the bypass and heads toward the zoo. So here we see the bridge. If you were coming from the east, want to go to the zoo, you'd drive up and underneath that bridge, on out there a little ways, and there'd be a curved road that curves around those trees over there, and swing you back up over the bridge, and you head to the zoo. If you're coming back from the zoo, and you want to go west on the bypass, you'll come over the bridge, come around this cleared area here, and the road will blend on out there in the distance into the bypass heading west. So that bridge serves two functions, bringing some traffic back from the zoo as well as a way to get traffic over to the zoo. So here we coming back out around here. Just looking at the Staley's Farm Road area there. They're having to cut through and the bridge they had to build there for the new section of the road. Making a lot of progress reshaping the roadway on out here. As you go down this slope and on around the curve to the right, around the base of that hill, maybe another mile on out there. The road goes on out and then swings back to the left. And that's where that roundabout's gonna be, right at the zoo entrance. So once you get to this point right here, you're pretty close to the zoo. From where I was standing, my signal was blocked. I couldn't go much farther than right here. Turn to come back. It's another look at the bridge built here at the Staley Farm Road area. A little bit of work going on just the other side of it there. Dozer and an excavator digging out, getting part of the roadway down to the correct level there. Working that slope on the other side. Now we're going to swing on out around and go on out a little further on the bypass out. This is heading back toward Old Cox Road. Right here is where it's crossing Staley's Farm Road again. And down just ahead on down there a little ways is where it crosses over Zoo Parkway, and they're building the bridge down there. So let's slide up here and take a little look at it. Off to the left, right up ahead, there's the Crossroad Retirement Center off to the left up there. on off in the distance, you see the old Cox Road, and way off in the distance, Highway 42 is way on out yonder. So right here is the bridge that's going to be crossing Zoo Parkway. We're working away at it today. Now the drone's going to come back and try to find where I am and land. So that's episode 212 of the 64 Bypass Update Series. Appreciate you coming along for the ride today. We'll have another episode up in a few days. Have yourself a great day.